Why are we shouting out Big Taff Man? I'm pleased. Everybody should just go back and watch Big Taff Man. What a man. What a Big Taff Man. He shouted you out, to be fair. I've just seen in my... I was really confused. I was just watching the chat and I was like, shall I go live? And then I saw that there was a... I saw there was a shout out for Taff and I was like, what's happened? Oh yeah, Taff's live. Has he raided? And then I was confused. Taff has just told me to come and watch you. Taff. Thank you very much, Virgin M. It's lovely to have you here. Anybody who's come over from Taff, appreciate it. Appreciate you. Appreciate Taff. Do not clip the start of the stream and send to Taff. Taff deserves all our support. And all our love. Especially when he has the little gremlin of self-doubt which seems to creep up into his head every so often. We need to find that little gremlin. We need to chain it up. And we need to torture it. I don't necessarily condone that stuff usually, but I think in this situation it's necessary. Should we move on? Good morning, everyone. Hello, Fluffy Pink Blonde. My day's is kind of going okay. I'll tell you more about it in a minute. It's been good. I think I'm all right. Frolicles, bang, midday, bang. Here we fucking go, straight in the chat. At midday. Is it Darcy's birthday? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Darcy. Happy birthday. Oh, God, that sounded like sincere, like I was doing my best voice. I can't believe that we're all here together. Happy birthday to you. Three cheers for Darcy. Hip, hip. Hooray. Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Hip, hip. Hooray, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us, so say all of us, and so say all of us, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny, which nobody can deny, which nobody can deny, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny.
Happy birthday, Darcy, valuable member of the community. What else is happening? Who else is here? Herford, how you doing? Hope you don't have any meetings. You, Herford, tend to have meetings during the days if you've got a job. Hello, Domella. Happy Thanksgiving Eve to you. Do you do stuff on Thanksgiving Eve? Some people have Christmas Eve traditions. Obviously, putting out stockings... wrapping presents, brining a turkey. Are there like traditional Thanksgiving Eve things to do? I genuinely don't know, and I'd like to. Hello, M. Don't know. How are you? Happy Thanksgiving Eve. I've always wanted to try a traditional Thanksgiving feast. Sweet potato casserole always sounded interesting. Me too. I think when I lived in London, when I was like, hip and cool and had free time and just did whatever I wanted every day with my mates and, oh my God, I had hardly any responsibilities. There was a period when I did a job that I didn't really care about, so you just clock off at 5 o'clock and not think about it. I think we did a Thanksgiving thing, a meal with an American person we knew, I think,
But I want a proper one. I want to go to America and have a proper Thanksgiving feast. It just blows my mind that you do it this close to Christmas. We're literally a month away. We're going to be doing feasting all over again. Anyway, Tomela, no presents for Thanksgiving. It's all food and sleeping and American football. Yes. Yes. Happy birthday once again to Darcy Sato. Thank you once again to Taff for sending people over my way. What else? Follicles. Thank you very much for your question. It seems a bit superfluous due to the late start, but tradition is tradition. Have your bins been collected? Yes. They get collected at like 7 a.m. now. Recycling has been collected. Thanks for your question. Hello, Powerful Khan. Good morning. Llama, hello. I'm happy that Beeb was clapping. No, you were clapping and Beeb was dancing. Imagine if Beeb started clapping. Could that happen with wings? Do any birds clap? My opinion of birds might improve if I hear that some of them clap. I suppose penguins clap, do they? No, that's seals. A bird would have to dislocate their shoulder to be able to clap. And I'm against that. Good morning, Dr. Nop Nops. One of my favourite names. Hello, Blake Town. How you doing? I've seen your thoughts on the crossword today. I'm not going to be influenced. Virgin M, you open presents on Christmas Eve. My cousin sometimes does that. My cousin's the kind of person who receives her birthday cards. You know, if you're lucky enough to get birthday cards in the post in the run-up to your birthday. Birthday cards, if a card arrives 3 days before her birthday, she just opens it and puts it on the mantelpiece or windowsill or wherever. But then you get to your birthday and then everything, you got nothing. Hate it. Some countries actually open presents on Xmas Eve, says Frolicles. Yeah, is that like in Scandinavia, do they do that? I feel like they do that in Scandinavia. M don't know. Stream trip overseas for a Thanksgiving party next year then. Yes, let's do that. Let's make that a sub goal. Let's do a sub goal for me to pay for 20 people to head over to the States. Yeah? How many subs to take everyone abroad? Domela, sleeping after a meal is usually referred to as the itis. I can't do that now. Now I've got a child. Christmas, Christmas, obviously, multiple huge levels of extra joy having a child. Boom. But, you don't get to do the napping after the meal because there's brand new toys that need to get played with. Or there's a child who's going mental because they're cracked up on sugar who needs to be taken out for a walk and some fresh air. So you don't get to do the nap stuff. Also, my daughter got up at 20 to 4 on Christmas Day last year. 20 to 4. Here's what happened. Mummy or daddy? I'm like the Limmy meme. My wife gets up, goes in. I hear a little voice. Has Father Christmas been? My wife. Yes. I'm in bed. She said yes. Why has she said yes? A then 6-year-old child is not going back to sleep. She was hyped. She knew she had a stocking of gifts from Father Christmas to open. I was like this. They came back in and I had to be... Obviously, I was like, oh, Merry Christmas. Father Christmas has been. But I said to my wife, why didn't you say no? If you say no, then you say no because it's 20 to 4 in the morning. Sorry. Let me mute WhatsApp. I might have to reply to something work-wise. I'll just mute my laptop. Say that it's 20 to 4 in the morning and that Father Christmas hasn't been, so you have to get back to sleep. Anyway, I'm hoping that it won't be as mad. Part of me sat up in bed that morning and was like, well, this will go down in family history. It's 3:40. I was down in the kitchen making a cup of tea at 3:50. I'd had three cups of tea before 6 a.m. Frolicles, particularly looking forward to seeing the crossword today. Wasps asks the important questions. Do birds have shoulders? And Llama, bird expert, says they've got arm joints, ? Wasps replies with, they have arms. Llama says, wings be arms. We're learning. Hello, Weetabix Licks. How you doing? Nice to see you. Blake Tam, we have Xmas Eve presents. They are always new cozy pyjamas and slippers. I've heard about that kind of tradition. I know a lot of people who do that. They get their kids and the whole family new pyjamas and stuff for Christmas Eve, which is pretty cute. We don't really wear pyjamas. I suppose my daughter does, but I'm not a pyjama guy. I think we've touched upon this before. I'm not a pyjama guy, guys. Right, let me just close down this thing. Balls to naps, we have games to play. It's Christmas, yes, all day, says Weetabix Licks. Okay, it sounds to me like you're a fun person to be around at Christmas. As long as you definitely leave at some point. No offence, Weetabix Licks, you sound like a fantastic festive person. Fluffy, we woke up to stockings on our beds so we would stay and play with them and not disturb. Yeah, I used to wake up to a stocking on my bed, but I'd always want to open it with my brother and sister, my older brother and sister before they moved out, and I'd want to do it like I like taking it in turns. I'll pull a little gift out of the stocking and I want everybody to look at me so I can go be like react, and then I want my sister to have their go and everybody to look at them. And in fact, when I got together with my wife and I had my first Christmas with her family, they do things quite differently when it comes to presents. They deal out the Christmas presents under the tree. They take them and they give them to each. So everybody's got a little pile of presents from each person. Very lucky, very fortunate to have gifts at Christmas time. And then they all just start opening them. Whereas we, in my family, hand them out. We hand out one and we're like, oh, look, this is for Dad from Adam. And then we watch Dad open the present from Adam. And then we get another present. So I was at my wife's house and I'm like, what the, this is chaos. Oh, have you opened the present? I've got a receipt for it if you want. Oh no, that's really cool. And I bought that for you because I thought you'd really like it. Do you remember when we did that? Yeah. I like all that shit. Meanwhile, my wife came to do that and she was like, why the fuck is everyone watching? Why is everyone in the room is staring at me like this? And the pressure is on to unwrap the gift and to appreciate the gift. And then you get the whole, my mum would be like, now I know it's not necessarily your size and I know you're not a fan of that colour and I've never ever seen you wear that kind of item of clothing before. And I know that you exclusively have said that you don't want any animal products. And this is a giraffe leather jacket that I've bought you in XXXXXXXL. I do have the receipt. It would be quite tricky to get back to the little gift shop that we went to when we went on safari. But I can, if you're not sure, and you have to let me know if you're not sure. And my wife would just be like, I love it. Hello, Tallulah Fluff. How you doing? My wife does not have a giraffe leather jacket. And my mum and dad have never been on safari. Hello, Cade. How you doing? PJs are for after you get up and not dressed yet. What? So you get, like, what do you suggest? I have PJs just on the floor that I get up and I put on PJs in the morning. I just put on some, I just put on a dressing gown or some tracky bottoms. Powerful Khan, so sorry. Powerful Khan, did you know that children getting sugar high is actually a legitimately false misconception? One of many that might make you question your sense of reality if you check out list of common misconceptions on Wikipedia. Really? I feel like I've literally seen it happen. I've seen children have sugar, lots of sugar, and then go wild. I want to try and stop saying mental. It's not the best choice of words, is it? Anyway, I believe you though, Powerful Khan. In fact, list of common misconceptions, Wikipedia sounds like a really great Wikipedia page to read. Follicles, if anyone in UK likes KFC, yes, they have an offer on the app. Spend £10 and get a free 6-piece bucket. Oh. 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 Did you see this? Oh. See what this is here? This is me Googling Scroobius Pip's tweet. Because he said he's done the best tweet he's ever done, and I had no idea what he was talking about. Why has that come up on this Google when I did it? Oh, because I'm signed in. I don't want to be signed in. Sorry, that's obviously a distraction. But Scroobius Pip did a tweet, and then he said it's the best tweet he's ever done, and I didn't get it. So it can't be. Anyway, what am I doing? McDonald's muffin. Festive. I was going to write Christmas, but they won't do that. What website do I want to go on? Let's go on Lanks Live. I may have just doxed my email address. That's fine. I don't mind. People are welcome to email me. Did you see this? This has happened today. I'm so sorry that it's 2 hours late and you can't go and get this. And I have also apologies to any vegans or veggies or people who just detest McDonald's or large corporations in general. I hear you. But I also fucking love McMuffins. This has been released today. The Mighty McMuffin. Sausage, bacon, egg. You choose ketchup or brown sauce. It's got cheese. Oh, fuck yes. I need to have this. I need to have this. Sorry, I'm now catching up with chat whilst you guys look at a big old muffin. Just enjoying chat now. You're just watching me enjoy you. Tallulah Fluff, I also go hyper after eating too much Haribo. Yeah. Playtime, so exactly my problem with tracky bottoms. They're essentially pajamas. I'm always judging people wearing them outside the gym. Basically the same as going to the shops in your dressing gown. Yas. We talked about this the other day. I still can't understand people who just wear jeans inside or shoes. When we get home, me and my wife, I'm not afraid to admit it. The first thing we do is say, should we get in our cozies? Okay, maybe I was afraid to admit it. But I'm like, oh, should we start dinner? Oh, I just need to get in my cozies. And we get in our cozies. Which basically means changing our whatever we've got on our legs. Should we get in our cozies, guys? I'm in my cozies now. I'm in a really cozy fleece. First off, I'm in a really cozy fleece. This is incredibly cozy. And it's got the elastic around the wrists is just giving my wrists the gentlest and the most tender of hugs. Both wrists just feeling incredible right now. It's a lovely material. Good morning, Cudder. Welcome. How are your wrists? And then I've got tracky bottoms on, and I've got socks, and I've got my office slippers on. So, oh my fucking God. Oh my God. Tallulah says that needs a hash brown in it and it'd be perfect. Let's go back. I hear you. I quite often, when I get a sausage and an egg McMuffin, I always put my hash brown. If I get the meal, I always put my hash brown into the muffin. But this has already got an extra layer of bacon. So if you add the hash brown as well, that's going to be a... Things are going to slip out, slide out. But I'd probably do it. I'd probably do it. Good afternoon, Captain Moobs. It's freaking me out, people saying afternoon, because I usually start streaming in the morning. And I therefore feel like it's the morning. Really getting into tracksuits? Yes, Cade. Herford wears jeans around the house, but I find them pretty... You find them pretty comfortable. M don't know, you call them lazy pants. And yes, as soon as we get in, need to get comfy. I love the idea of the No family getting in from a hard day out. Lazy pants. Let's get lazy pants. They've got a little, they do like the little, it's not a handshake. What's that called when you do? I know this, but Josh and M do the LAZYPANTS. Yes, it's lazy pants time. And then they snog. Oh dear, I made myself. It's embarrassing to make yourself laugh, isn't it? Anyway, let's catch up. So yeah, I'm feeling all right today. I'll let you in to a little secret. I did a podcast this morning. I appeared on a podcast this morning called Reach Out for Mental Health. And it is a podcast put together by a charity, an Essex-based charity called Reach Out for Mental Health. Is that the charity name? Or is that just the podcast name? I should really check. But one of the, it's the charity director, and then the other host is Stu from Pod Bible. And they talk about mental health, and I should probably give a bit of a trigger warning. We're not going to get too deep or go into this heavily, but we're just having a good time. So I was literally just talking about the No family and their lazy pants routine. But it's a charity that focuses on suicide prevention and then also support for the bereaved and stuff like that. So I was invited to go on because obviously I've had some experience of this kind of stuff over the last week. There you go, Josh. What a legend. Linking to the website. The last week? Sorry. Ignore me. In the last year. And I went on and I spoke about my friend and I spoke about the experiences since and coping and the importance of talking about it, and therapy, and what happened. And it was quite a deep old chat. And then I finished, and I was like, oh, I was going to, should I stream? And then I was like, yeah, I feel okay. I'm having an okay day. And I think that's the main thing about it. The further I get from it, the more okay days I tend to have in a row. And streaming's fun and you lot are great and it's nice to be here. So yeah, but it was kind of good. I spoke to his wife a few days ago to check. It was cool for me to go on it, you know, just to say I'm out there. I like to, guys, did you know I'm quite open and I like to overshare? Did you know that? And I'm happy to be vulnerable about stuff and I think it's really good to talk. And she was like, and I said, I don't know, I feel a bit weird talking about this on a podcast, but it is for mental health and it is to help people. And she was like, go for it, please. Like, I'm really open as well. I'm fine for you to go on there and talk about it and talk about Tom. And he would have loved it. He would have gone on that pod if he could. And he would have loved it. And he would have listened. And he loved talking about it. He loved talking about all this stuff. So, yeah. So I went on it and it was decent. It was good. It was hard sort of talking through some of the specifics, which I didn't really expect to talk about, but they kind of came out. But yeah. The main thing, and I was asked to give some advice at the end. They were like, if there's anybody listening who might be having negative thoughts, or if there's anyone listening who might know somebody or be worried about a friend, what's the deal? What would your excuse? What would your advice be? And I'm part of me's in my head thinking, don't fucking ask me. I'm just a guy. I've got no training in any of this. But I just said, I know this is cheesy because the charity is called Reach Out, but reach out, reach the fuck out. And mainly focusing on if you've got somebody in your life who you think may need some help or that kind of thing. Just reach out. Don't listen to this and think, yeah, shit, yeah, 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 yeah. And then think, I'll do it tomorrow or I'll do it next week. Or yeah, maybe in a few weeks, maybe after Christmas, I'll get in touch. New year, new me, we'll see, we'll do some stuff. Just do it now. Just do it right now. And you don't need to send a message saying, hi, yes, I am worried about you and how are you? Just say hi. Just say what's up. Just say, did you see the World Cup match? Just say, did you watch I'm a Celeb? All these things nobody's doing. Did you see there's a new Mighty McMuffin that's got bacon and sausage in? Do you want to go and get one? Or just send a fucking gif. Just start a conversation. And then you can judge it from their response. Do they respond? Do they respond quick? What kind of things do they bring up? Have the chat. That could lead to a call, a FaceTime, a Zoom call. Go out for a walk. Whatever it may be. But yeah. Do it. Do something. And then I went, do something. And they went, that's the coolest thing we've ever seen. Do you like the way I always fucking do that? Is that some sort of coping mechanism or some sort of... I'd speak seriously and then I'm like, oh, this has got too much. I'm going to be a dick. Frolicles, I've got a friend who suffers from depression this time of year like me and we both help each other, which is nice. That is great to hear, Frolicles. Keep doing that. And keep speaking to your friend. And I'm really glad to hear that they are helping you out too. You've been diagnosed with cis man syndrome. Oh, no, what can I do? Domella, the feedback I've gotten from families over the years is that they're afraid of bringing up the subject of self-harm because they think they'll give their family member the idea. Yeah. That's something as well that's interesting. I think a lot of people are afraid to bring certain stuff up. And I reckon 90% of the time, I don't know this for sure, and like I say, I'm not an expert, but I've done a fair lot of thinking about this stuff and I'm reading about this stuff and listening to podcasts and stuff like that, but I'm not an expert. But 90% of the time, the thing that is a huge deal in your head and won't necessarily be that big a deal. For example, I know a few of my friends who are kind of afraid to reach out to my other friends, to my friend's wife and kids and stuff, because they don't know what to say. They don't know what to do and they don't want to bring stuff up. And I get that. I don't get it because I don't have that. I'm happy to talk openly about everything, but I do get that some people don't feel comfortable. But I kind of think just do it, just give it a go and talk about these things. A lot of people I know are like, I don't know what to say. I don't want to talk about Tom anymore. Like, I don't want to bring that up in case it makes the family sad. And I know some people might like avoid talking about it with me. In the early days, some people didn't talk about it with me because they were probably like, they don't want to worry me or make me sad. I want to talk about it. And I know that my friend's wife loves talking about him. If he comes up in conversation, then her face lights up because she gets to remember the person she loves. Oh God, Tallulah Fluff, I lost my bestie from college like 23 years ago in December. It does get easier for sure. I'm really sorry to hear that, Tallulah. But it is reassuring. And yeah, Dr. Knop Knops, it's not the easiest of things to talk about. It gets mega intense. I get that too. If you honestly feel like you can't, maybe you have somebody in your circle of friends who might be more confident or open or isn't something, it's something that comes naturally to them. I remember when we were in our teenage years, I had a friend who was annoying another friend, but the friend who was getting annoyed was like, oh, I feel like I can't talk to them about it because I can't articulate what I feel and I'm just going to get wound up. And they said to me, do you think you could talk to them about it? Because you're good with this kind of stuff. And I was like, yeah, I'd love to do that. I like mediating and like, I'd happily have a chat with them. So maybe if there's a friend that you're worried about or somebody in your life that you're worried about and you're not 100% sure, check in with another friend and be like, have you spoken to this person? Or would you reach out? Or I don't know. Anyway, I'm talking as if I'm some sort of expert. Powerful Calm, my coping mechanism made me really, really, really want to make inappropriate jokes like your stream makes me want to reach out. Well, that's fine, Powerful Calm. I would expect nothing less. By the way, if I miss anything that any of you have said in chat, if you've sort of shared something poignant or personal and I haven't responded, it's because I've missed it. Sorry. I remember when I had a big chat about this stuff a while back, I went back and watched some of it and a couple of people had shared some stuff and I was like, fuck, I missed that at the time. And Damela lost somebody as well 27 years ago. So big love. Powerful Khan, you're onto something there. Hereby ends the heavy section.
Fruit salad, yummy, yummy. Fruit salad, yummy, yummy. Fruit salad, yummy, yummy.
Yummy, 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 yummy. Fruit salad.
Lent salad, yummy, yummy. Fruit salad, yummy, yummy. Fruit salad. Yummy, yummy.
Yummy, 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 yummy. Fruit salad.
Fruit salad. Yummy, yummy.
Wow.
Fruit salad. Yummy, yummy.
Oh, it's good.
Fruit salad. Yummy, yummy.
Don't turn off. Don't switch off. Fun section now. Fun section for the rest of the stream. Talking can be fun, though. What a lovely bunch you lot are. Right. So today, I haven't been drinking. So today, I'm going to finish Superliminal. If you were in yesterday, I think we were close to the end, but I had to stop because I had a meeting. So Superliminal may be only like 5 minutes long. And then we'll do something else. But we'll get onto that in a bit. Damela, love that song, but I hate the sound of people eating juicy stuff. Oh, do you? Did you fix your disgusting hat yet? Llama, I rubbed my skateboard on that hat and it made it all dirty and dusty. I don't know, because I like that one. I like the fit of that one. It feels really comfy. But it's kind of, and the way that the lighting works, if I wear that out and about, you can't see. You don't see that. But because I've got a ring light there, as you can see, it lights up that bit of the hat. It was already stained. I know it was, but I think it's like a bit of sweat. But that is gross enough to maybe just bin it. I bought it in America. How bad is the hair, like on a scale of 1 to 10? Not that bad, actually. I nearly wore... I nearly didn't wear a hat today, but then last second I did. So I'd say on a scale of 1 to 10, the hair is 5. 5 bad. Anyway. Hey, how about behind the scenes seg one day to see your setup? We could do that. I was going to do that for Show Us Your Stuff. Show us your stream setups. Get a load of streamers involved. Llama took that idea and did a massive, massive steaming poo on it. So then I didn't do it. My office is pretty tidy right now. Is there anything that is controversial? Hey guys, that's the door I go out and in. And I've put some black tape, I put some black stuff to stop people being able to see in the old garage door. Now the fucking mic, what's this thing that you look through? Camera is not staying still. Okay, fuck it. Here's the light. Here is my gym area. These are some growlers, like beer growlers. Here's various different bits of artwork. Here is my cross trainer. Here's some more sound foam. Here's my TV, which I never actually turn on. Here is some kettlebells. Here is a like medicine ball type thing. Here are some weights. Here is a mat. And here's the picture I haven't put up yet. Here's another picture I haven't put up with yet. Can you open the wee door in the wall? I can. It's just got a fuse box in there. It's just got some sort of fuse. I'd show us your growler. There's my skateboard shelf. There's a little loft. There's a whiteboard. That's a picture of me and my friend, which you can't see. That's not my friend. Here's the ceiling. Here's me. Here is the background. There's some pictures of my wife and child, which is fine. That is fine. I don't mind that. It was very quick. And that was quite a while ago as well, so they both actually look completely different. This is fucked now. Thanks, Josh. That would have been too easy, right? Too bright? Ooh, interesting. That needs elves. Ass, ass, ass. 10:30 loft stream incoming. Ah, oh, imagine if I got... No, it's a tiny little roof. I'd basically be able to lie down in there and that's it. So there you go. Just checking, I'm now paranoid. If there's anything in here that you shouldn't have seen. Thanks, guys. Hey, you were here. That was a moment. There's lots of people, I imagine, who've been in this stream before who was like, what's over there in the room? I can see a little teaser in this mirror. You lot got to see it. I flashed it, but you got a good old hard look. You come down when I'm not in, do you? Imagine if you live up there, eat stuff in the freezer. Ooh. It's bigger and tidier than I thought it would be. Yeah, that's why I thought I'd turn it round, because it's actually quite tidy. I am very happy and lucky that I have this room. If anything, I spend a bit too much time out here, and because it's not part of the house, it's a bit, I feel a bit disconnected occasionally, but that's why I try and make sure I don't spend all my time out here. You actually meant the computer tech components. Oh. Sorry, one sec. I was just going to flash. This is my laptop. This is me live on Twitch. That's me showing my laptop and saying, this is me live on Twitch. That's me saying, this is my laptop, and that's me live on Twitch. Live on Twitch. This is me saying, this is my laptop, and this is me live on Twitch, and this is me live on Twitch. This is me on my laptop saying, this is me on my laptop saying, this is a me on my laptop, live on Twitch, live on Twitch. So this is my laptop. Hello, Les Dennis. that's what I used to do all my streaming from, and it just couldn't hack it. Couldn't hack audio and OBS and shit like that. My PC is under my desk, and I can't, if I take all the cables and stuff out of that and pick it up and bring it up, that's going to be bad, isn't it? Is that going to be bad? The thing is, I know you wouldn't put it past me. I know you wouldn't put it past me that I just unplug everything and then hold it up and go, why is the screen gone black now? Do you have two monitors too? Oh, how can I show you that? Oh, like this. Just double check there's nothing I don't want you to see here. So para. I've got some notes here, but I don't think that's got anything important on. I just know that you can freeze frame. Here are all the notes. Here's my big monitor. Here's my laptop. Here's my Stream Deck. Here's my two-button mouse. The Apple keyboard. The Apple keyboard. My nephew, my 18-year-old nephew, is over from Australia. He's coming back later. In fact, he might end the stream early if I have to go and pick him up. He was like, oh, mate, can I see your setup? And I was like, yes, of course, let's go. Brought him in here. He was like, oh, rack off. That mic is wonga. Because they say Wonga now. And I said, thank you very much. And he said, you're going to have to upgrade that mouse and keyboard. Oh, I was doing all right. But guys, I've put a gaming mouse on my Christmas list. My wife was asking me for some present ideas for her and like my mum and dad and stuff. And I've put a gaming mouse on there. It's like white and it's got holes in it. And it's got a button on the side and a button. It's got like four or five buttons. And it's like got little neon colours on it. Because at the moment I have a Logitech. Miss Dennis, you also have a Logitech G403 Hero. I'm very happy with it. I mean, Logitech's probably a good brand, but this is like the most basic mouse. I've had it for ages. they're pretty gross. You spend a lot of your day with your hand on these things. Keyboard wise, I don't know what to do because the Mac keyboard works well when I'm 90% of the time when I'm on my computer. I'm on my Mac. If I've got a PC keyboard, I don't know. I'm kind of happy with the keyboard. And also, if I get an amazing gaming mouse and gaming keyboard, then I've got absolutely zero excuse for being shit at games. I do have a proper IT department mouse now. And that is so true. You sent one to Pip last night, Llama. What, a link to a decent gaming mouse? And now he's actually fixed his. So apparently Llama has been, well, we all know that, well, we don't all know. Some people will know if you go and screw his Pip's streams that Llama's been trying to get Pip to adjust his mouse settings or at least get a new mouse or something, because we hear when he's just trying to turn right, he's constantly moving the mouse like that. And so I don't know if it's mouse sensitivity or whatever it is. But finally, I think Llama made some progress and he's changed some settings. It was quite funny to hear. He changed it and then he was like, oh shit, where is it? Oh my God, where is it? It should make a decent difference, shouldn't it? If you sort of slowly change it and you get to grips with it, that's going to make a world of difference. 100 dpi. I don't even know. I mean, is that dots per inch? I don't even know. Actually, 100. What's normal? How can I find out mine right now? Let's do this. Wow. What a stream. I'm going to find out what mine is. I don't know what to do on a PC. Settings? Devices? No. He's gone up to 2,000. Oh shit. Have you seen Counter-Strike players with their ultra low sensitivities literally waving their hand across the desk to look 45 degrees to the left? Where do I find the devices? Here we go. USB optical mouse. Oh, can only it's remove. I can remove it. Settings, devices, mouse. Settings, devices, mouse. There it is. Okay. Mouse pointer speed. Is that what we're looking at? No. I mean, mine's set to 6. Related settings. Lines to scroll at a time. Mine's set to 3. I would recommend going to PC World, etc. to try out different mouse types. Learn if you're a claw or a palm grip. I like this. Just classic. Just absolutely classic. You'd have to use your mouse software. Okay, fuck it. Fuck it. No, it's. I don't know if it's actually interesting enough to delve deep into what DPI my mouse is at, but I'm happy with it. And you don't ever give me any grief for scrolling around loads when we're playing games. Buttons, double click speed. I'm at halfway between slow and fast. I've got the classic pointer selected. I've got, oh my God, I'm actually bored now. I'm actually bored. I think I'm on a regular human DPI. Quick reminder that this is now available in all McDonald's. If you're into your greasy meats. Powerful Khan, what's the weather like? Shit. Grey, rainy, miserable. Thanks so much for asking. Right, let's smash. Ad? Have you got an ad? Do I get ads? Do you guys see ads? Anybody who's not subbed, do you get ads? Do you get pre-roll ads for me? I've never touched any of my ad settings. I'd happily never run ads. Do you? But you have to, right? Oh, me talking about Mackies. I'd happily never run ads. Should just have pre-rolls. By the way, thank you to anybody who subbed, and I appreciate it. But what I realised is, for most of the people that I sub to, I've just got rolling subs. And I rarely click on the share or celebrate or whatever it is when I go into their stream. And quite often they renew on a day when they're not streaming or when I'm not in. And that made me realise that there'll be loads of you lot who do the same thing. So you don't get me saying thank you to you. You don't get the little pop-up alert and then me going, oh, thanks so much for your sub. Which is just a nice gesture and I like doing it. So big up anybody who's subbed to me who does that, who just lets it renew each month and doesn't make a big deal or doesn't get me an alert. Thank you. I just thought I should say thank you to those people. I love you. 90s hurdle. How long before the loud noises emote? Thank you, Josh. I did say to Lama yesterday that I was going to look at my audio and... look at the volume mixer and turn Firefox down a little bit. Okay, it's at 100. I've just turned it down to 85. Let me know. Let's have a skip. Just a little bit longer. Oh my God. Yeah, Les Dennis, I don't do anything. I just adjust, like in OBS, I just adjust the levels for things and I just leave it. Yeah, Viva Forever. I think you're right, M Don't Know. Subbing is not as powerful as Kofi. Thank you very much to Powerful Khan, who is number one Kofi supporter and a legend. And thank you so much, is what I'm telling you. I appreciate that. I think it is Viva Forever. I don't mind this. Chronicles got it first. Oh yeah. I apologize, I just got a bit too sexy. Quick. Is that the start of Heaven Is a Half Pipe? I don't know, Moobs. It's Spice Girls. I think I need to ignore Frolicles. I might have to give Frolicles a little time out every time we do these. Is that going to be the start of... Ding, ding, ding. Sorry. Ding, 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 ding. If I die before I... Wait, it's not that. It's not actually that. Evanescence. Josh might be onto something here. Spice Girls turn you sexy. Watch. I hate that I did that. What's that? Hooberstank. Although Hereford, haven't you watched Limmies? Reason. It is Reason. Oh. Is it not that? is that? Thank you very much for the Ko-fi donation. I haven't got an alert who that's from, but whoever it is telling me to stop singing. Thank you very much, whoever's done that. Do you think it's broken again? I'm just checking my emails now for alerts. It is that, isn't it? We got that, guys. Well done, Hereford. I knew it though. I was singing it, wasn't I? Perfectly. Oh, guys, I need a better chair. My neck. My back. And that's where I'll stop. Okay. Naughty's rock. Naughty's rock.
As a mile seems pretty. As a mile seems pretty. As a mile seems pretty.
It's something shit, isn't it?
As a mile seems pretty. As a mile seems pretty.
1,000 miles seems crazy.
As a mile seems pretty.
Is it loud as fuck? Hey there, Delilah. What are you doing to me?
As a mile seems pretty far.
See, that is a bit louder in my ears, but it's not like awful. I'm not like. Be right back, sausage and egg sandwich for lunch. Were you inspired by the muffin? No, M don't know, it's not. Alright, let's do it. Let's go to my Hurdlify. This is a Hurdlify. It's a playlist of my favourite songs. As in songs that I've rated. And I need to clarify, since I was like 15, 16 and I first started making playlists. So if this is if there's a shit song or a problematic artist, it's old me. I've changed. You can't cancel me. Let's see what's on my playlist and then we'll get shuffling and find out what's on some of your playlists. I'm always quite nervous about this. Cade, I did go back and... Did I? No, I didn't remove Guilty Conscience. I don't feel guilty about it. But this is good. This is like, yeah, Clara, it's like a chance to cleanse my playlist. Anyway, here we go. New donation from buy a very, very cheap and uncomfortable old chair. But very, very... Thank you so much, by the way, whoever's doing this. It looks like it's Powerful Khan for all of them. Or at least the first two. Thank you, Powerful Khan. You hero. What is this? Ah. I'm going to know it. Is it Wolf Alice? I think it's Wolf Alice. But I've got quite a few Wolf Alice songs on here. It's not that, and it's not that. I don't think it's that. I'm going to guess this. Shit. It's not war paint. I don't have any war paint. Can't remember the names of their songs. It's definitely not You're a Germ or Beautifully. I say that, it's going to be one of those. Well, it's going to be one of those. Actually, I think it might be this. It's not that though, is it? Fuck's sake, let's just listen to it one more time. Did I guess Freezy? I think it's that. Okay, well done. Wow, great content. Okay. Let's shuffle.
Every day I'm shuffling.
This is where you get to shuffle your songs and we get to listen to some of them. It's going to be so great. Oh my God, it's going to be so great. I just keep thinking about how great it's going to be when it actually happens, and I think it's going to happen right now. Let's go over here. Where's my Spotify? Look how ready you lot are. Where did I put the Spotify window? Oh, here it is. No, Spotify, I do not want to listen to 100 Greatest Christmas Songs. Crossword's coming. Don't worry about that. Crossword's coming. All right, Darcy was up first. Now, that you have to be legit. I don't want anybody shuffling their phone and then skipping until they get a cool song. If the song's shit, you don't have to tell me. I think you're all cool anyway, no matter what songs you end up shuffling. Let's do this quick. I'll tell you what, I'm going to be really judgmental quickly. Killing Joke, a band I've never really given a chance. Until now. Hate it. Arnold. Let's try a bit more. Thank you, Powerful Khan. Ready for the song now. Jump in. Should I get into Killing Joke? Oh, look at them. Just bought an album. Oh. They've been bringing out albums every fucking year. Okay. Didn't mind that. Liked it. Arnold by Luke Millian. Is this the Hey Arnold theme tune? Oh, it's about Arnold Schwarzenegger. This is a shuffle from Frolicles. Okay. We're getting there. Oh. Oh, guys, my hips. Oh, no. My hips. Oh, shit. I'm grinding. Oh, I'm doing the overbite. Oh, I'm going to have to pause it because I was doing an overbite and I was grinding my hips. Let's skip in a bit. Although 45 seconds apparently is where Arnold comes in.
Hi, this is Arnold.
Yep, okay.
Your instructor.
Let's skip in. Never heard of this. Never heard of Luke Millian. Arnold is the most popular song. He did the Stranger Things theme. Wow, okay, cool. Did he? Really want to take you to a club one night. Yes, Cade. Oh, it's been so long. I do worry about how I might behave. Thank you very much, Frolicles. So that was Arnold by Luke Millian. We've got Ailstorm by Ailstorm. Is that right, Josh? Ailstorm. As always, I'm going to do 5 of these. I say always. I used to do 3. I say always. And I've only done this twice. Is this... What's the song called, Josh? Is it just called Ailstorm? Hold on a minute. I feel like I recognise these pirates. I feel like Divin Inc. has played Alestorm. Here we go. Divin Inc., as we know, is a massive Sea of Thieves player. And they're very problematic. Actually, have I seen this on your stream, Cade? It was Cade or Divin Inc. I think it might have been your stream. Maybe both. Okay, well, they're problematic, so we won't give them too much airtime on this incredible platform that they'd be blown away to hear that they've been featured on. Connection by Elastica. Elastica's another one that I never really got into. I think my sister was into them, but no doubt they've got loads of bangers that I've forgotten about. Oof. Oh, of course. This might just go straight into my 4 and 5 star playlist. It's a classic. Is this all going to get muted? Love their sound so fucking much, but they're cunts. Sorry, you're still talking about Alestorm. Alestorm the band and the song, but looks like they're cunts. That is cancelled again. Providing a platform for a wrongins again. This is trigger happy, isn't it? God. Oh, Cade. When did this come out? Cade, I can totally imagine you listening to that in your early teens, walking around feeling like a grown up. For some reason, I'm picturing you dressed as Harry Enfield or as Kevin. Is it Kevin? Kevin and Perry? It was Kevin and Perry, wasn't it? Anyway, how many have we done? We've done 4 or we've done 3? Pandemonium, Arnold, Alestorm and Elastica, that's 4. So we've got one more and I'm scrolling down and it's Llama and it's SFC by Silvertide. Here we go. Llama, it says fucking it within seconds. Why don't you just try to see it on my way? So on brand. Cause I'm really not liking what you have to say. Some of the best guitar tunes out there is a big. That's a big call. Really anyway. One album. Only one album. Imagine me getting into this at a certain period of my life. There we go. That was Let's Shuffle.
Every day I'm shuffling.
Should we do the crossword? Let's do the crossword. That's the wrong thing. Let me just remove that. I can't. I'm going to need a separate scene for the shuffling Spotify stuff. Right. Do we need a winner? Should we have a winner? We don't need to have a winner each time, but which song did I enjoy the most there? Let me just go back and scroll up. Was it Pandemonium? Was it Arnold? Was it Alestorm? Was it Connection? Or was it SFC? It's going to be Connection. by Elastica, because it's a song that I do already like and had forgotten about. Cicade is the winner. So the rest of you, you have two options. You either leave the stream or you delete your entire music collection. As if anybody's going to be like, but I cannot leave the stream. Try better next time, losers. We don't need a winner, do we? As if that's like an on a level option. Two options. Leave the stream or delete all your music. I nearly clicked raid. I nearly clicked raid like I was going to leave the stream. Start prediction. Start prediction. I'm doing it again. Talk about someone else. Talk about someone else. There we go. Get your bets in, guys. Get your fucking bets in. Because we're about to do the crossword.
And we play and we play and we play and we play and we play. Every day, every day, every day, every day. We're gonna do the crossword, crossword. We're gonna do the crossword, crossword. We're gonna do the crossword, crossword. We're gonna do the crossword, crossword.
Who sang this originally? Well, the Blazing Squad did a cover of it, but it was by somebody else, wasn't it? Bone Thugs. Anyway, thank you so much, Frolicles, for the music. At some point, we'll have a little video to accompany that music, so you don't have to see me sat here listening to it. Do you want a true story? A couple of weeks ago, I spent the whole evening, a whole evening, with the lyrics to the Blazing Squad version of that song and me rewriting lyrics to match up with crossword, like working out new lyrics to go with the crossword stuff. And I had a plan, which was to send those lyrics and me recording them over to Frolicles and say, do you fancy making the full version? And it took ages, and I just thought, I don't know if this is any good, and I don't need full songs for everything. We don't need to sit for 3 minutes before each crossword. Oh, before each crossword? So, yeah, it's a little sting instead, and I don't have to give Frolicles more work, but I might get a little video. Should we have some Wyeth Quispies and do the crossword? Fuck's sake. Anyway, so this is the mini crossword, Wednesday, November the 23rd, 2022, by Joel Fagliano. He's back in the hot seat, baby. And I've heard that he's done crossword crimes. Do? That do. You guys have spread. Spread? I was about to say spread your bets, but that is actually a thing you can do, spread betting. You haven't. You've committed to one side or the other. 94% are saying no. Four people have backed me, and those four people will do really well out of this if I do well out of this. So let's hide that. Shall I do it like this? No, cannot. I always forget what size I actually do it. I think I go to 80%. No, that's 67%. Yeah, so you can see. So my camera's not in the way. I love a bit of spread betting. I got well into like spread gambling years ago and never like spent loads of money. I'd only do little bets and I'd put like 20 quid in. And it once I lost it, then I wouldn't do it again for a few months. But at the end of the day, it's all just stupid and you just lose your money. Okay. Wish me luck. I've got to try and do this in 3 minutes for anybody who's new. Let's crossword. Keep the beat in a way. Don't know what you mean. Person you might feel embarrassed around. Anyone. In good spirits. I mean, is that just going to be happy? Elite group of colleges. Oh, well, that's an American thing, isn't it? And I don't fucking know. School, that's... Why is it highlighting other ones? School, that's the furthest south of the seven across. Oh. Well, absolutely no idea, because I don't fucking know about the American schools or colleges or anything like that. So, fuck you. Have a hankering for. Crave. Werewolf professor in the Harry Potter books. Snape? No. Ah, I don't know. Ah, I can't think of any others. It could still be Snape if Happy's wrong, although then that means that word is, it's got two A's, so it's not Snape. Colorado ski resort. Oh. Banff? Is that in Colorado? It isn't, is it? Banff is in Canada. Something Ed. Oh, nice. Co-ed? Guacamole scooper chip. Okay, Happy's right. Happy's right. Seven across, elite group of colleges. IV. Don't know. Five across, person you might feel embarrassed around. Person you might feel embarrassed around. Don't know. Keep the beat in a way. Clap? That's a way of keeping the beat. By clapping. Should we put clap in? We're not going to get this, are we? Let's pretend it's clap. What Harry Potter book? I read the first three Harry Potter books when I was like 19, and then I didn't finish, and I haven't seen any of the films. Or maybe I saw the first one. Three down, Colorado ski resort. Four down, something Ed. Ah, oh, this is a shit crossword. What do you mean, Ed? It might not even be clap. School that's the furthest south of seven across. Elite group of colleges. This is rubbish, isn't it? Three down, ski resort. I don't know if clap's right. Why? I mean, what kind of clue is that? Keep the beat in a way. Five across. Person you might feel embarrassed around. Christ. Is you'd feel embarrassed around Christ if you spelt his name like that. Okay. Let's pay out. Let's go to Discord. I haven't paid out, by the way, just in case you think I haven't paid out. I'm going to pay out. I just need to go to find Funkle Albert and find the sad music he made for me, which I should actually download and put in OBS. But now I'll pay out. Will I complete the crossword? No. Let's see what people had to say. Deary me. I missed your question, didn't I, Llama? I just realised. I'll answer that again in a minute. Lots of Americanisms. Ivy League. You won't know Phys Ed. Phys Ed. Hey, so clap is right. I know. So we think clap is right. Lupin, two down, werewolf, Professor Lupin, that does ring a bell actually. What is this? They fixed eight across, said seven down earlier. Okay, Aspen, and you've been there. I do know that. Crush, you'd be embarrassed around your crush. We shouldn't get to hear that, should we? Ivies. I don't think I've ever heard that. Elite group of colleges, the Ivies, and then Penn. I have heard of Penn. I haven't heard of Ivies. Phys Ed I've heard of, but that wouldn't have come to me. Aspen I am aware of, but I forgot. Lupin, again, I remember that now. And I got most of the others. He's already done so much better than I did. Blake Town, that actually, that's a win for me then. That's a win. Wake Armour payout than I expected. I thought you might throw something. Do you know what? I think after having a big conversation on a podcast this morning about mental health, I feel pretty chilled about stuff. I think that's helped put things into perspective again. Doesn't matter if I do badly at a crossword. I don't think I'll ever get grumpy about a crossword ever again. Absolutely not true. This is so Ben Folds. Send me the playlist again. And what? The Ben Folds is like that slow, sad piano music. Can we make a minor slowed down version of the winning music? That would be really good. That piano music is Funkle Albert playing the piano, by the way. Ivy League colleges or Ivies, that makes sense. Okay, I have heard of Ivy League. What's a podcast for the folks at home that don't know? Is there anybody who doesn't know what a podcast is? I mean, it's funny you should ask that. Because I explain fully in Pod Bible magazine, which comes out every 2 months, and I'm the editor of the magazine. This is the latest one with Brett Goldstein from Films to Be Buried With. It features a whole raft of interviews, reviews, recommendations, and bonus podcast content. It tells you what is a podcast, just in case you've never listened to one. And you don't know where to get it. Are they free? How do I actually listen to it? What does subscribe mean? I fucking explain it all. Podbiblemag.com. Thank you, Powerful Khan, for giving me that opportunity. Blake Town's in that one. Blake Town is in that one. Cool, you read that? How does one obtain a Pod Bible? Podbiblemag.com. Oh. There's a shop bit. You can subscribe £8 a year and you get all issues sent to you. £8? All issues? Yeah. Yeah, that's what I said. Can you send me one if I send you another Ko-fi? Yeah. Yeah. I can, Powerful Khan. I can send you one without another Ko-fi. If you email me your address, I will send you one. Okay. We're going to get onto games now. And I think we're going to try and finish Superliminal. I really enjoyed playing Superliminal yesterday. It was really good fun. Sent you a WhatsApp, says Llama. Add it right now, do it on stream. Oh, but I'm going to have to open WhatsApp on my PC. Because at the minute it's just open on my Mac. Don't pretend you didn't screen grab his email from earlier. If you email shirshyourstuff@gmail.com, that gets forwarded to my email anyway. So then I reply. Loads of you have done that. I reply and it's my personal email address. Literally a year's worth of Pod Bibles on Ko-fi today. Okay. Khan, do I have your address? Email me your address and I'll add you. Do you know what? I'll add you to the yearly subscription. Although I've got to then post it to Canada. But you've been very supportive. We'll see what we can do. Right, where's my WhatsApp gone? Why have I lost WhatsApp? It's refusing to open. The icon at the bottom is missing. When I click on it, it's not opening. Sorry, Llama. It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get this playlist. Oh, here we go. It's opening now. What a kerfuffle. What a faff. It's now asking me to connect. Tap menu, settings, link devices, link a device, take a picture of this QR code. Llama, yeah. Yeah, Cade. Go to Llama's chat. Click open on the Spotify playlist. Open in Spotify. Come over here so that you lot can see and have proof that it's happening. Oh, I legit hadn't read the title. Llama thinks I'd like Ben Folds or Ben Folds 5. And so has made a nice playlist. Just under an hour. Ben Folds 5 for cunty bollocks. Now I'm getting WhatsApp alerts. So let's close. Let's now close WhatsApp. Okay, look. Look at this. Okay. All done. All done. Let's get the game up. Why isn't the game coming up straight away? Game capture. Superliminal. There we go. I actually don't have chat in front of me now. Where's chat gone? I felt a bit bad. Let's listen to this.
Well, I thought about the army. Dad said, son, you're fucking high. And I thought, yeah, there's a first for everything. So I took my old man's advice. Three sad semesters. It was only 15 grand. Spinning bed, I thought about the army. I dropped.
Sorry, guys. I was going to like joke about the fact that I was bored. And I realized that I've looked at my watch. And apparently... apparently, I've been doing yoga. Apparently, I've been doing yoga for 4 hours, 24 minutes, and I fucking forgot to turn it off. When I did a bit of yoga, that like mobility stuff this morning, and I fucking forgot to stop it. And all my daytime stats are going to be ruined. It says I've done 1,500 calories of yoga, but in 4.5 hours. I'll tell you the truth. I did 20 minutes because I just wanted to do some stretching. Oh no. I'm just going to have to delete that. Can you delete active? Does anybody have an Apple Watch? Do you know if you can delete workouts? Because I don't want that on my stats because that's not accurate. I'm going to have to take off my watch and go and do 4 hours yoga now. Just so it, you can edit in the fitness app. Thank you, Tallulah Fluff. Thank you, Llama. That did sound good. That sounded catchy and fun. And Funkle Albert would probably like it as well. Let's recommend it to Funkle Albert. Now, Tallulah Fluff, the question is, do I do that now? I do. Here we go. Edit. I can't, anyway. Ah, it's annoying when you don't turn it off after. I sometimes do that when I go to play football and then I get home and I haven't turned it off. Anyway. Thanks very much for your question about piss, warm piss. Right. Thank you, sorry. Your valued channel points were used for that. Thank you so much, Llama, for everything. Powerful Khan, yoga is Ad's custom title for when his watch detects he's in the Wankatorium. Frazz Waffle redeem what's in the freezer. Why Squispies? Rice Krispie Squares, cookie and cream. Hello, Graham's Nan. Hello, Graham's Nan 32. I'm very well, thank you. You joined me just in time for me to eat a Rice Krispie Square out of the freezer. So sticky. Frazwaffle, why freeze them? Because I'm running out of stuff to put in the freezer. Before my streams, I frantically run around the house being like, what now, what now? Oh my God. Oh. So brittle. Brittle is the word for that. None of the lovely chewy sensation you get with them. They're supposed to be like unctuous. Makeshift mum, have you learned nothing from 10:30's broken tooth? What happened to 10:30? I know that he's had dental issues. What actually happened, makeshift mum? I missed it. Did it happen on stream? Can we send you stuff to put in the freezer? Yes, I would absolutely love that. Brittle as Mary Berry. Oh. Brittle as our friend Johnny Arscott, Uncle Albert. I'm going around trying to get people to see my new beat on YouTube. Are you Graham's Nan? And how are you choosing which streams you go into? Is it completely random? I'm surprised that you saw a man taking something out the freezer and having a bite of it and thinking, yeah, this is the right channel. I'm going to stick around. Only streamers with cool hats get chosen. Cade, don't get yourself connected to ads crimes. I'd happily receive something from Cade. Llama has said no thank you. So that's that. Oh, Graham's Nan. I'm just excited that... Does Graham know? Does Graham know that his nan is making beats? Good luck, Graham's Nan. We're okay. Actually, legitimately, if you'd come in about an hour ago when we were doing lots of music stuff, may have gone for it. But right now we're moving on and we're going to play some games and stuff like that. So best of luck to you and your lovely grandson. And good luck with the beats. Good luck, everybody. Is that WhatsApp boops? Can you hear WhatsApp stuff? I don't actually know now. I don't have any other alerts coming through. Anyway. Does Graham have a cipher of 31 other nans? Right. I'm closing down Spotify now. Do you know what? Actually, I feel like I need a little break. Who wants a song to get stuck in their head? Oh, you lot.
OpenUpGaming.Amazon.com. Sign into your account or go set up a new one. Choose a payment method, complete the transaction. You're on your way to giving me that Prime Sub satisfaction. Now open up your Twitch accounts on the Amazon site. Enter in your details, be sure to get them right. I'll be succinct, your account's now linked, so we're nearly done. You've done the prep, now one more step while admin is fun.
Alright, stop.
This next bit is key and you've got to get it right. If you're subbing to me, go to twitch.tv/add to send me cash. Click subscribe then free subscription with Prime. Oh fuck, you've done it. You are the best. Your taste of streamers is sublime.
One more thing, do not forget that in just 1 month's time, your sub will expire unless you renew again with Prime. Your resub would be awesome. If you do it, I'll be glad. Make your own decision, so, cause I'm not your dad.
I'm not your dad.
I spotted it straight away. I spotted that straight away. All I did was stand up during that. It's quite good standing. I'm getting a standing desk at some point. I've been researching standing desks. So I'm going to get a standing desk. I'm just replying to one email. Perfect. Love the inclusion of the Megan stuff. Sending this to our digital editor. Boom. Yes. The problem is, Kate, I want quite a wide and narrow desk. And a lot of the standing desks that I find are quite deep and also narrow. Anyway. Yeah. And also, I've got all this gear on it with my mic, and then I've got my camera on a shelf. And I kind of want... I don't know if... Yeah. But then they don't go that high, do they? I kind of want... You need to be able to see what I can see. Anyway, it doesn't matter. My headphones are fine. This is how they go. Do you know what I watched last night? Travis Barker's Top 10 Essentials on GQ. Who was talking about this? Oh, my nephew. My nephew was talking about YouTube channels he watches, and he says he watches Top 10 Things I Can't Live Without on GQ, which I'd never heard of. So I found it, and he said it was good. And Travis Barker's done his Top 10. And one of his things were these Bluetooth headphones, which look fucking great. But he didn't mention the brand. At least I don't think he did. In the video notes, there was no mention of the brand. I Googled it. Like, which headphones did he talk about? I couldn't find it anywhere. And I feel like you missed a trick there. But then I guess that could lead to people like being like, hello, we've heard that you're going on the GQ Top 10 Essentials. We'll pay you $1 million to plug our headphones or something like that. Anyway, I want Travis Barker's headphones. What are you hearing? I can't hear anything. I am getting WhatsApp messages though, so it must be that, because it's since I downloaded WhatsApp. But I'm getting WhatsApp. I haven't got WhatsApp open. Am I going to have to uninstall WhatsApp? Your privacy settings blocked access to your location. Was it that sound then? Cade, what are you doing in the tray? That sound was something about my privacy settings. And I've just disabled all notifications about privacy. It's lovely to have you in the little tray there. I'm actually very happy about that. Right. I reckon that'll be it. Llama, why have you sent me a video of your bird and your foot? It's not yours. Okay. Is now the time, Llama? Is now the time for this? Should I show it on stream? Is it safe? Hold on. Sorry, guys. Feet are TOS. Llama! By the way, makeshift mum, sorry, did you say what had happened to 10:30? No, that's fine. That is actually a great video. Thank you so much. It's a shame that it's not you. I wish you'd do something like that. I wish you'd do something like that. I wish you'd hurry up and do something like that. Okay, let's play the game. Hello, Wasps. Welcome back. Let's play the fucking game. Let me sort that out. Let's turn off those notifications. Quite like this. I quite like this music. He says exiting the game. You reckon I might still have an hour left? Okay. AirPods Max wireless headphones, Frolicles. Have you just done the research? Have you just done the research? Honestly, why does this keep happening to me? Here we go. That's not what I wanted to do. This is going very well, I'd say. Why does it think Firefox is fucking closed down now? New window. Absolutely hate this. How much are they? That's what I want to do. That's what I want to do. I want to Google them. Are they fucking expensive? That's you lot. There we go. AirPods Max wireless headphones. Oh. Are they Apple? He didn't say they were Apple. I didn't know Apple did headphones like this. But the way he described them, like the way that they can, the connectivity and stuff. And the sound cancelling. Yeah, but he didn't call them AirPods. He didn't call them AirPods. I just thought the black ones, I thought they looked cool and they look comfy. But I'm not spending 550 quid. Absolutely no way. AirPod Max are the best things I've ever listened to. Non-Apple fanboy here. Is this the AirPod Max? Pazza. You'd want that for 550 quid. It would need to be. Yeah. Right, now that's WhatsApp giving me fucking... Why am I still... It's because I've downloaded WhatsApp. Right, notification settings. Turn off all notifications for WhatsApp. There you go. It was WhatsApp. Somewhere WhatsApp is open, even though I've looked in the tray and I can't see it in the tray. I'm such a pro when it comes to PCs. Yeah, that does look like that is them. Frolicles. They look comfy. I want to feel that mesh, springy mesh bit on my head. You've got these, Pazza, but you got them for 300. You got these green ones. crazy. Everyone's crazy. Anyway. Let's get back to this. I used to have Sennheiser everything, and then what have I got? Audio Technica. These were just recommended for podcast stuff. For clarity of voices. Whenever I'm in Discord calls with Pip and Llama or Cade and Guzbo, whoever, they just sound absolutely incredible. Your dad used to have some headphones and it was comfier wearing them than without them, says Dr. Nop Nops. If I dropped the link in here, Llama, would the world explode? Pazza! Send the link. Oh, is that going to work? Are those little... Oh, it's a Spotify. Llama Riffs. It's another Spotify. Right, fucking let's play this. So, this is our fourth stream, Superliminal. I was hoping we're near the end, but it sounds like we may have about an hour left. But I don't mind, because I'm really enjoying it. It's been a bit of a head fuck at times. We needed Blake Tan in the chat to help us get through. But it's fun. It's a good game. It's a good, fun game. I'm going to eat the rest of that Rice Krispie Square in a minute. It will have defrosted. I don't think I like the cookies and cream one. Hey, Div.
This is highly unusual. It appears you have entered the Somnasculpt diagnostic framework. Patients do not have access to this dream.
Oh no, we were here, weren't we? Oh, I couldn't work out what to do here. So we're here. And we come out here, and that is this. Or something. Blake Town said something about... Did I get a drink? Was I going to go and get a drink? I said I needed a break, and I just stood up for a bit. Old man losing the plot. Rosemary, why am I standing up? Something needs to be done with this. But then I've got to get up into there, Blake Town. And I can only get in there... Actually, can I... If I make this big, or I make myself small, but at the minute, nothing happens when I come in here. I have to go into the door. There's nowhere to go though. My only option is to go through here. Make it big. Make it so. Okay, fair enough. Make it big. That's what she said.
Diagnostic warning. Unrealistic use of dream objects may result in
Amy.
Integrity fail state. States.
States. How you doing, Amy? Nice to see you. We just started playing this again. So, hello, not nice David as well. Look at these legends coming in together. Very much enjoyed watching David playing PUBG last night. Fantastic clip. Are we going to go and watch that now? Yep. Are we going to get distracted from the game immediately? Yep. This is not me considering buying these, by the way. We were just looking at them. Because they are Travis Barker's favourite headphones. Who's this chump? Who's this chump? So last night, Scrooby's Pip shocked us all. Ah! Last night,
Scrooby's Pip shocked us all. Ah! Last night, Scrooby's Pip shocked us all. Ah! Last night, Scrooby's Pip shocked us all. Ah! Last night, Scrooby's Pip shocked us all. Ah!
This is cool. Shocked us all. Ah! This is cool. Shocked us all. Ah! This is cool. Ah! This is cool. Scrooby's Pip. Scrooby's Pip. Scrooby's Pip. Scrooby's Pip. Scrooby's Pip! Scrooby's Pip! Scrooby's Pip! Scrooby's Pip! Scrooby's Pip! Oh! Scrooby's Pip! Oh!
Scrooby's Pip!
Oh!
Scrooby's Pip!
I don't want to go to chat, do I? Clips. No, rhythm. I have got rhythm.
I can't believe that we're all here together at the same time. You're in my chat, so we are best friends now. I think that's how it works. Are you my best friends or what? I provide stuff for you to watch, and you provide me with I can feel the love. Is that love? I think it's love. Is it hate? I don't care, cause you're my best mates. You are my best mates now. Please never leave me. Don't go away. You cannot go away. We're your bestest friends. I can't believe we're best friends. Bestest of the friends in the world.
Imagine all the Superliminal fans who are like, oh my God, 2 hours and we haven't even got to the game. Oh, cool, he's playing it. Anyway, last night, Scrooby's Pip surprised us all by doing a stream and playing some PUBG. Not Nice David jumped in. Funkle Albert jumped in. Box Social jumped in. Guzbo jumped in. Llama had a fucking mare. Have you sorted that, by the way, Llama? I hope you're back. Anyway, this is a cool thing that happened when Not Nice David and Scrooby's Pip were playing by themselves.
Too far with it.
Nah, we just want to get into a
Hold on. Sorry. Because you can't see Pip. Oh, don't do that. Why does he always fucking do that? Select my camera. What have I selected there? Lock that. Chill out, everyone. Lock these things. Lock that. So I can actually select the thing I want to select. Lock that. There you go. Everything's fine. Put me over here randomly. Here we go.
You're not going to go too far with it.
Nah. We just want to get into a Oh, there's a lot of pops. Ooh. Hello.
Oh, well, I'm dead.
I died as well.
David, you're laughing. Crack me up.
Oh, fuck.
How did that kill us both?
I don't know.
We just killed everyone in Pachinki. I said the words, I trust you. And then you crashed and we died.
Perfect. Absolutely beautiful. I love it. There's been some amazing... Shut up. There's been some amazing PUBG moments recently on Pip stream.
How do I do it? I don't even know how to do it.
Hold F4.
Yeah, not that one.
Hold F4.
Yeah, not that one. Not that one. Oh, dear. Okay. Okay. I've closed it now, Darcy. I've closed it. Okay, let's watch that one. Fuck's sake. Let's fucking watch that one then. La 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 la. 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 It's a bit sexy, actually.
Rock.
How do I do it? I don't even know how to do it.
Hold F4. Actually, do you have F4 on your shitty Mac keyboard?
Oh, no.
Oh, ads vanished.
Oh, no.
Guys. God. Did you just press Alt F4?
No.
What did you press?
So,
Ad.
It's me and you, David.
Ad.
I said,
what did you do?
Ad is now playing PUBG Battlegrounds. I've just had a notification. So that's loaded up.
I imagine Ad has pressed Alt F4.
Oh, dear.
Ad.
That's a great start, really.
Did Ad Alt F4 it?
Ad.
All he wanted to do was do a little dance.
Why did you do that?
I just equipped my fucking dance. And I'm on a Mac keyboard, so I press Control F4, nothing happened. I press Command F4, and then the key between those two is off. It's my Mac keyboard's fault. Yeah, yeah, get another keyboard. Where's this one?
Kada, oh look, it's Kada. Look there, it's Kada. Yes, it's Kada.
I'm all right, Divin Inc. I'm all right. I'm going to be fine. It is Kada. Right, the game. I don't know what I'm doing with this level, so we're going to have to work it out. Basically, if I go through... you get smaller every time you go through it. You get smaller every time you go through it. So that's an immediate problem. Shout for Cudder. Exactly. I've gone off the boil on doing my shout-outs. And if I go that way, then I get bigger again. Make it small. Now, pop it on the table. Oh, now that we've done... Okay, yeah. Now that I've actually done the process of making this into some weird portal loop. Make it small. Pop it on the table. Then we'll go through here. And now we're on the table. And we're small. But we've been in this position before. And... Darcy. Do we slot it back in and then maybe this door becomes something. Go through again and get tiny. Go through what? This? No, that sends me back into this way. What do I do? What is it that I do? It's good. Yeah, but the other way.
Diagnostic warning. Paradox prevention protocol.
I go over there. It's going to take me ages. And then I'll be absolutely tiny. Why do I want to be absolutely tiny? I mean, I shouldn't question anybody. Can you open the garage door? No. It just makes me pick up. The other building. No, can't interact with it. What's going on with this music as well? But the problem is when you go really small, it goes really slow, Josh. Like, to get over there would take about 10 minutes if I got smaller. Pretty sure you need to get into one of those. Okay, well, looks like we're doing this now because I am fucking... There must be a tiny little gap to get into one of the buildings. Protocols may not be fully implemented. Reset to checkpoint. Reset to checkpoint. This is highly unusual. Thank you. I forgot I turned that to zero. It's quite loud, isn't it? Is it loud? It's loud for me. No bits required for that anymore.
Diagnostic warning. Unrealistic use of dream objects may result in dream integrity fail states.
Right. I've got a bit of an idea of something to try. What happens if you take it through? Wasps, I think that's what you're meant to do. Maybe not. Yes, everything's fucked. Get paradoxed. Thank you, wasps. Look how bright this is. Hello? Hello? Hello, darkness, my old friend. Oh, I thought that was in the game. I've come to talk with you again. That would be quite fitting, which is why you played it. Thanks for the bits, Div and Ink. Not an exit. I'm definitely going in there though, right? Oh, what? What's happening? Go in here then. Whoa. That was crazy. Hi, Glenn.
Hello. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and many years ago, I had a dream. I found myself in a place where I understood that each of us begins as nothing, where everything I perceived was shaped by seeing it exactly the way I wanted to. White space.
Okay. I'm happy for you, Glenn. This reminds me a bit of being in a whiteout when I used to go snowboarding, and what a freaky sensory experience that is. I totally just zoned out then. My vision went all blurry. Oh. Glenn. Come on, Glenn. What are you playing at? Where am I going? It is trippy. It's good though, isn't it? Stuff like this, like I'm just imagining the dev team sat around a table and being like, and then we'll do this, and then they have another token they join and go, and then we'll do this. Sorry, Fluffy. Oh no! What's happened? I didn't mean to put it through there. What's happening? What? It was there. Okay. What? Oh, weird. Just let me make it big. Will that do? Yeah. Glenn?
But in white space, I also faced the greatest challenge I could imagine. Because with a lifetime of life itself behind me, and all of the weight that it carried, I realized seeing things the way I wanted to was not as easy as it used to be.
What do you do when you play games, Blaketown? Are you... What should I be doing? Should I just be taking in absolutely every detail? I do actually try and rinse it. I am enjoying the vibes, the atmosphere. What did you say, Glenn? Feels a bit like heaven. I didn't spot those labels. Can't go round. I can't. Why can't I go round? This is making me feel super chilled out, like I could just drop off. Yeah, I don't think I play any games like that where I just spend ages exploring. I just want to get stuff. I mean, more for me, obviously. I just like to get through, get stuff done. Right, there doesn't seem to be anything else that I can grab. Actually, I think I'm kind of providing a service because you lot can watch. Some people who haven't played this can watch and be like, and then you might be like, do you know what? I'm going to get that game. Because even though I've watched Ad play it and complete it in record time, there's so much more that I could explore. When I'm reading, I just read the chapter titles. Cutter, this is what I imagine those sensory deprivation tanks would be like. I've been in those. I've had three sessions of those. Actually amazing. Right, what the fuck do I do here? Wasps. Wasps is a clever boy. Yeah, Stardust, I agree. The first time I did a float tank, spent the first half hour being like, well, this is shit. I'm just thinking about loads of stuff. And then before I knew it, it was over. And they were like, yeah, you've been in here for an hour and a half or an hour. And the second time I did it, I got zen really quick, just didn't think of anything. And you come out feeling so unbelievably chilled out. Yes, yes, sleeping. Oh, I should do it more. I should go back to it. I mean, it's not the cheapest thing to do, but... You can have... when I was in there, the first time I went in one, I lay in there and I was like, do you know what would make this great? The radio or a podcast. And then that obviously completely defeats the object. Did I just come from... Have I just gone back on myself, or am I? I kind of have to focus. This day, so I want to smoke so much weed I can taste the sun and then go into deprivation tank for an hour. I reckon I'd go so deep I'd end up having brunch with God. For fuck's sake. Do it, although I'm not sure they'd let you in. Okay, right. I'm going to have to do something here. Oh, my nephew's on the train from Victoria. I need to finish this game. Okay. Let me know when you're... Sorry, guys. I've just got a reply to my nephew. Such a head fuck. Get Neffy on the stream. He'd love that, actually, probably. It'd be a bit weird, though, wouldn't it?
You're well beyond dreaming now, and further out than anyone has ever come back from. But we hope that you won't get discouraged. After all, if this is a place of pure perspective, isn't it also a place where a different point of view could make anything possible? Isn't that why you came here?
Exactly, Josh. I know if I brought him on stream, straight away, Powerful Khan would ask something inappropriate. There'd be piss stuff. You'd redeem what's in the freezer. Not all of you would be horrors, but a few of you would be, I'm sure. This is mad. Oh my god. Massive water cooler. Whatever, Blake Town. Yeah, Walls. Do you remember when Walls did that when I thought my mum was around and he asked me about shitting or whatever it was? Shitting out my eyes. You want to know what he thinks of you and see a young person. It's not a good enough reason. He says he's going to walk regardless, so I don't need to pick him up from the station. Okay, cool. Ignore that. I won't ignore that, Blake Town. Whoa. I'm gonna rack him walk. That's true, Josh. That's the one I just came in, isn't it? Ah! Why can't I go on the black? Do this. Oh. Okay, maybe I just make it. Do you reckon I can just go around? No, there's a wall there. But it looked as if I make this really big, I can be close to it. Oh, this isn't going to be it, is it? Catch it! Aztaz, you legend! How you doing? Welcome in! How you doing, Aztaz? How's your stream? What were you up to? I popped in earlier, actually, and lurked for a couple of minutes, and you were doing some speedrun stuff? Speedrun practice or something? Thank you so much for the raid, Aztaz. We are playing Superliminal. Have you played Superliminal? Hello! Hello, Reedy, sorry. Hello, the Rizzle. Speedrunning Resident Evil 2 remake. Nice. Were you doing training for it, or were you actually doing the proper run-through? I'm hoping to finish Superliminal right now. We're right near the end of it, so if you've never played it and you want to play it, feel free to shut your eyes. But it's a good game. I've been enjoying it a lot. And everybody, if there's anybody in here who doesn't follow Aztaz, Aztaz is just... it's just next level. Thank you for the follow, Reedy, and the Rizzle. Training, I would say, is I always die at some part. At one part, Superliminal is a Class 3 game. Okay, you've played it. Cool. Thank you for the follows. Thank you for bringing your lovely people here. I hope you're doing all right. We're going to get back on it. So, it looks like I can... if I'm close to these... I don't know if this is a good idea. This is... is this it? I mean, it's working. I don't know how close I have to be to them to stay upright. Basically, at the minute, If I walk over this grid without these chess pieces and I just fall through. For anyone who's just joined us. My name's Adam, by the way. Have I told you that? You can stand on the squares they're on. Ah! That makes more sense. So I immediately fucked it. Oh my god, I hate this. Okay, so I'm safe. That makes loads of sense. So this is now much easier. I was about to say much easier. Don't pick it up. Don't pick it up. Until you're ready. Astas, thanks so much for your question. That's a very original question I've never had before. Where did you get that lovely idea? Would you rather bath in hot piss or cold piss? Oh. Because usually it's warm piss I get offered. Let's go hot. Hot piss. I reckon that could be quite an experience. We were talking about sensory deprivation tanks just moments ago. Hot piss. Thanks for your question. Look at this. Look at this. It's as if I know what I'm doing after getting it wrong loads of times. Oh, the temptation to turn and pick it up immediately. Oh, I nearly did it again. We don't know if we need one here, but we're going to do it anyway. So glad we made it. What's this all about? Do I just go through here? Or do I need to go out there? It looks like I need to go out there, but let's have a look through here. Oh, it's not real. Catch it! Hold on a minute. I'm not going to be able to get up there. Let's see what happens if I walk into the black. Nothing. Can I go around the side? Nope. Can I put this? You'd think by now I'd be able to just work this out straight away. Rounders at school vibes. Catch it! That is true. I played a lot of rounders at school. I love playing rounders. Right, mate, got to go now as I'm taking Wee Big Man to his little tiger karate thing. Enjoy the end of the game. Thank you, Aztaz. Thanks for dropping in. Thanks for saying hello. Thanks for the question. I hope Wee Big Man fucking smashes little tiger karate. School run. Thanks, Blake Town. I'm fucked without you, though, Blake Town. I'm fucked without you. Can you just leave the kids at the school? Blake Town, before you go, how do I get through here? He's gone, hasn't he? Ah, that's let me through. And there's Big Cheese. Right. Everything's fine. Is that enough? I need it to be absolutely fucking massive. Oh, fuck's sake, why am I terrible? You think I would have mastered how to make things big? That's how you go my way, and then you look at it like that. That's how. Is that too big? Got to pop out for 10 minutes. I want you to complete this game. I want to complete this game by myself, but I love you, Ad. Thank you, Powerful Khan. Thanks for the Ko-fi donations. Send me your address. That is related, by the way. I'm gonna send Powerful Khan the magazine I work on. And thanks for your support and help. I'll see you next time, probably Sunday. Why didn't it let me do a cool thing and make that jump? Coming back, you just don't want to see the ending. Well, you don't know that I'll be done in 10 minutes. Now what? Just go on the black ones? I don't dare go on the... Or maybe I need to drop down. If my nephew's on his way home, I need to finish this in like 20 minutes. Photosensitivity warning soon. Thank you, Sam. Appreciate you saying that. Good to know. Anybody in chat, if you're not into the flashing and strobing of lights. I mean, this is kind of making me feel a little bit sick already. Music's great. What a game. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Ah. Oh, I'm in the alarm clock. Oof. What time is it? Oh, no. Thank you, Sam. I appreciate that. It's 8 a.m. What a game. What a game indeed. We got past 3 a.m. Is this... Am I awake? Is this real? I want to look down and see my body. Pinch myself.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce.
All right, Glenn.
And by now, you may have realised that all of this has happened exactly the way it was supposed to.
Whoa.
You see, everyone who comes to the Institute does so because they feel that they are no longer in control of something important to them. Often than not, the problem is not that the problems we face can't be solved. The problem is that we become so afraid of failure that we refuse to see our problems from a new perspective. And so, we do the same things again and again and again. And therein, of course, we find exactly the failure we were looking for.
God. This is quite affecting.
Your life will always be a struggle. And you will always have problems. But today, you have the chance to see things differently. Even though it meant facing obstacles that seemed impossible at first,
thank you, Sad.
Outside the box, and you overcame them. Because you saw things from every angle, you understood them for what they really were. Because you kept moving forward, no matter how far off the path you were told you were headed, or how unexpected it became, you found your way.
Oh my God, Glenn! Glenn! What an emotional day.
In a few minutes, you'll be back in the real world.
I don't want to.
Some part of you will say that none of this was real.
No, Glenn.
How could it have really meant anything? But just like the power of perspective itself, it will have been as real as you believed it to be. All you've got to do is wait up.
No. Wow. I thought that was in the game. Shout out Albert She. Shout out Logan Feith. Steve Allen, Ryan Sanderson. We should just enjoy this, shouldn't we? That is the most emotional thing since... Sorry. I'm really sorry. If you're new in, then I used to have some watermelon in the freezer. And then, anyway. Oh my God, what a game. That was such a good game. Yes, Sam. I've got a freezer here. And one of the redeems on the channel is you can see what's in the freezer. And I just had some watermelon in the freezer. It was only supposed to be in there for 24 hours. And I ended up leaving it in there for about 6 months. My nephew's not back yet. Sorry, Sam. I can't explain it, can I? Holy shit. What? I love that ending. What an ending. Imagine I didn't taste it. I had to throw it. Imagine if I had like spent loads more hours. Again, it's one of those games, a bit like with Firewatch. If I was playing it solo and I was fully immersed in it by myself, I could imagine that being an even more sort of emotional experience or a more like engrossing experience. And it was... It could have been, yeah, but it was still fucking great. Loved it. Those are the last two games I've played, Firewatch and Superliminal. They've both been great. I don't know what I'm going to play next, but no pressure. Sweet. Well, my nephew's going to be coming home soon. He's staying with me. He's an 18-year-old who lives in Australia, and he's doing a little world tour type thing, so he's coming to stay with me. He was in London last night. Game recommendations on a spin wheel. Tempting. Maybe, yeah. If anybody's got any other game recommendations, then feel free to let me know on here, on Twitter, Discord, wherever. Until then, let's just do a raid. Let's go see who else is around. Thank you very much once again to everybody who subbed and followed. And thanks to Aztaz for the raid. Thanks to my main man, Powerful Khan, my main man who I couldn't remember the name of. We're going to go and see 10:30. And it looks like it's going really quick. Oh, no, there we go. We're going to go and see 10:30. Stick around. Let's go say hello. It's been ages. Don't forget to reach out to your friends if you've got anybody you know who you think might be struggling or you haven't even spoken to for ages. Let's all text somebody that we haven't spoken to for ages. Anyway, let's go see 10:30. It's been a while. One of the best in the game. Thanks, everybody. Oh, hold on. I need to open up something else. There we go. lovely little bit of music. All right, see you later. I'll see you Sunday evening. Thanks, Sam. Hopefully see you again soon. Bye.